I want to quote one quote to you from Naomi Klein's book, and I think it sums up pretty much where not only myself, but my chapter of the Eyes of Walton labor at these days. On page 12, I don't want your hope. I want you to panic. I want you to feel the fear I feel every day. I want you to act. I want you to act as you would in a crisis. I want you to act as if the house is on fire, because it is. Brothers and sisters, our house is on fire. And our house is on fire nationally, our house is on fire internationally, and our house is on fire right here locally. And we have got to not only define what a Green New Deal looks like in general on a national level, but we've got to define what a Green New Deal looks like here locally. And once we define what that Green New Deal looks like here locally, we've got to build a movement that goes out and gets what we want and what we need and what is demanded by our future generations. And just to give you one example, the Izaak Walton League, one of our principles and the way we built our organization up to 60 dues paying members in less than 1 year, is we've decided that we're not going to preach to the choir. We've decided we're going to go out and we're going to find and build a congregation. So we go to schools, we go to churches, we go to community organizations, we go to senior citizens groups, and we talk about climate change, we talk about the petrochemical plant, and we talk about what exactly is going on in this area relative to questions people are facing, such as the cancer clusters in Washington and Greene County. People respond when we go to them and we speak not only to them about what they're going through, but we speak to them in a language that they can understand. And that's what we are here for, and that's why the Izaak Walton League has joined with the Sunrise Movement, Extinction Rebellion. We want to join and we want to build a coalition in this area that is local, that is countywide, that is region-wide, and that is a force to be reckoned with, and that is a force that's going to begin to speak and to act with one voice, so the powers that be know that they're dealing with a movement. And we've got a lot of contradictions when we build this coalition that we've got to address and we've got to deal with. We've got to get young people and old people to sit down and respect and talk to each other. We've got to reach out to the African-American organizations and communities and make sure they know that they're not an appendage, they're not something down the road, they're something and somebody that is here at the table now, and somebody that's going to begin to help us formulate this plan. And we've got to do the same thing with organized labor and with workers. We've got to reach out to them, and we've got to let them know that they need to be at the table, and we don't want to hear any more excuses. Earth Day is our opening shot. I want everybody here in this room to know that we have already over 40 organizations that have joined together to plan an Earth Day march and rally downtown that's going to be the biggest thing this city's seen in a long time. I guarantee you, half of the organizations that need to be there are not even there yet, and we need to make sure that this thing is big and this thing is broad and this thing is ongoing, and the Earth Day is only our opening step and our opening action. So I'm asking you all to help in this process, to join with us, to coalesce with us, to bring us your ideas, to bring us not just your faces and your ideas and your work and energy, but bring your neighbors and your families and your communities along. Thank you.